And here she is, ladies and gentlemen, Mary Martin, back again in the public eye. There was something about Mary, so says the Washington Post, about David Kaufman's brand new biography of Mary Martin, Some Enchanted Evenings. I've got to read you this opening paragraph because it's fabulous. Theater critic Walter Kerr described Mary Martin as smoke. Lyricist Oscar Hammerstein had nuns in the Sound of Music singing of Martin's character as a moonbeam, a wave upon the sand. Indeed, on stage in South Pacific, Annie Get Your Gun, and Hello Dolly, Martin projected a magical quality all the way to the last row of the balcony. For biographer David Kaufman, the challenge in writing Some Enchanted Evening is transforming smoke, waves, and moonbeams into something concrete on the page. He succeeds with a keenly observed saga. Congratulations, David. What an achievement. What an achievement. It's a massive book. It's too long, but other than that,
In fact, the audiobook version was published the same day, which was July 12th, and it's 14 CDs, and it consumes 18 hours.
You were going to send me the
And it's read very beautifully by Bernadette Dunn.
I
can still send the link. If you go to Amazon, where the book is, as of today, the number one bestseller in theater books at Amazon.
Congratulations.
I'm very pleased to report.
I still thought it was too long. But anyway, I had trouble. How long is it?
It's 420-some
pages. So I'm holding the book, and I'm spraining my wrist at the same time. Because I'm like, I had to read it. Big. I had to read it. Well, the part
like
about
Doris
Brazil,
Day was 630 pages.
It flew, as opposed to Mary Martin.
Does fly, quite literally.
Yes, she was Peter Pan, of course, touching all our hearts. The part about Brazil I could have done without. But the thing is, Mary Martin's career, which was astounding, was phenomenal. And we all loved her. She had an important place in all our lives. I can't believe I'm talking. I was just sort of breathless, so excited to see you again after so long, because you've been writing this for so long.
7 years, and in fact, it's now about a dozen years ago that I was cleaning out my parents' house, the house I grew up in a suburb of Cleveland, Ohio, and I discovered a photo of my 8-year-old self in front of the Christmas tree taking off, dressed as Peter Pan
too.
In a costume that my mother made for me. So I look back on my life, and I'm now a 65-year-old man. It's not young, and it's like my whole life was inevitable to bring me to this point.
Well, I always wanted to fly. I'm sure most kids did. I remember my mother saying in the last year of her life that, you know, she said, "You kids, you always wanted to fly. I think you were really upset that you couldn't fly."
And in fact, here's
the Wall Street Journal.
The Wall Street Journal, another enormous review of the book by Ethan Morton, and it's titled "The Woman Who Could Fly."
Yes, and she
as indeed she could,
and she flew
in so many different respects. Exactly.
And thank God they did that on TV, because she would be completely forgotten now. Because what Mary Martin was, which is so incredible and so unique, was a stage star. We have so few of them today. I mean, Nathan Lane. Okay, he's a stage star.
Bernadette Peters.
Well, can they sell out? Can they finance a
no,
show on their names?
No. And Mary
Audrey
Martin.
McDonald?
Mary
I love
Martin.
I love you, Audrey, being on the show. Again, you know.
Mary Martin was exceptional. I did, fortunately, see her perform live in I Do, I Do in 1966 on Broadway.
I never saw her live.
And it was amazing. You know, she claimed more than once and in many different ways that when she performed for absolutely everybody sitting in the theater.
Okay.
And
yes.
Everybody felt that way. And it was extraordinary to observe in a large Broadway theater where I saw I Do, I Do with her co-star Robert Preston, who was also quite wonderful, the original music man,
of course.
And few people realize this, but they both got their starts as contract players at Paramount, where Mary Martin made 9 pictures, and Robert Preston was her co-star in what I consider to be her best film called New York Town.
Look that up.
In
New
which
York
her
Town.
Other co-stars are Fred McMurray, Robert Preston, and Achim Tamaroff. It's a very sweet little film, and Preston Sturges, the great American filmmaker, was brought in at the last minute to salvage the film. He wrote, rewrote the ending, he directed the, redirected the ending for 2 weeks, and he made it a really fine movie.
She dominated the American stage, she really did.
She and Ethel Merman were the two leading stars of the Broadway musical during its golden age.
It seems as if there was hit, there was sound, you know, there was South Pacific, of course. There's little bits of that you can find on YouTube. Immediately go look that up. And you can get a glimpse, just a taste of what she must have been like. And I don't know if I ever told you this, but my mother wanted to be Mary Martin. I think it was her secret wish. My mother wanted it. She just thought she was...
Well, Mary Martin was also Scott's, actually.
She was the pinnacle, you know, the pinnacle of the epitome of the American woman. Dream, you know, that they could have this glamorous life, which you go into and quite... How many parties did she go to? You had to list all those people's names,
well,
right?
Not all of them by any means. But what is amazing, there's so many things that I discovered that I did not know. Everybody involved with the theater...
I read your whole book.
Everybody involved with the theater knew that, of course, Mary Martin was the star
of whatever
of Maria... As Maria von Trapp in The Sound of Music, but what very few people realized was that it was actually commissioned by Mary Martin and her husband. They commissioned Rodgers and Hammerstein to write that show for
her. I guess I missed that.
So Rodgers and Hammerstein never would have written The Sound of Music with all those glorious songs that we also all grew up with, if not for Mary Martin commissioning them to do so.
Well, we had, at home, we had the records, of course. My mother got the records. And so I knew The Sound of Music without having seen it, you know. And, of course, for some reason, my mother wasn't that crazy about South Pacific. I guess because that was the time of her children being born and she missed it. You know, I don't know. But anyway.
Mary did take South
Peter
Pacific.
Pan.
Mary did take South Pacific to London. She did it on Broadway for 2 years nonstop, then in London for 1 year. And what's amazing about that is that her son, who was 18 at the time, Larry Hagman, or 19, was one of the Seabees, so-called Seabees, in South Pacific.
Yes.
And another one was somebody that nobody knew by the name of Sean Connery.
Right.
Believe it or not.
Right. Well, so her
performing,
career...
singing, and dancing in South Pacific.